So even if you put just 1,000 in, you could double it.
That's the good news, is it? What's the bad?
Oh, straight up. It's licensed to print money, this is.
You had 3 years in Dartmoor thrown in.
Same again, George.
You're going to be a loser all your life.
Takes one to know one.
Steve?
Yes, please.
I'm talking to the organ grinder, not the monkey.
Leave him out of this, all right?
Now, look, George.
No, you look.
All I'm saying is...
Want a gin and tonic as well, though. Behaving himself, is he? My favourite nephew.
Well, yeah, now and again. No, he's doing really well. I do.
Don't muck me about.
It's good to hear.
Be there.
Do you stay long this time?
Back to business.
Not as long as Martin would like, by the look of the thing.
No, come on. How much do you make from this tea bar?
It's not a tea bar.
It's a restaurant,
well,
I love you.
Well, roughly.
Tell him to mind his own business, Dad.
Just £3,000, Sam. £5,000.
A suspended sentence if you're involved.
For £1,000 stake, you'd be mad to turn that down.
Martin, there is no way I'm going to invest any more money in one of your scams. And that's vital.
Well, hear me out, bruv, at
leave
least.
Leave it now, Martin.
Flogging Shergard comes to mind.
Martin, leave it.
Keep out of this, you!
Hey, don't you speak to cattle like that.
I don't want to know, Martin, all right? End of story.
Look, let me... Get
on out! Let me... Drop. You're deaf as well as stupid. I said out!
Right!
Come on, Martin, where are you? Can't get away that easy.
Oh, you know what I think of Martin? He's bad news.
What's he after?
Well, he wants us to back him in some dodgy deal, as usual. Thinks Dad's a soft touch, that's the trouble.
Yeah, well...
Yeah, all right, maybe he is. But I'm not. I'm not going to part with it. Not now Dad's finally making a go at things.
Yeah, well, I think you got the message, Steve.
You reckon?
Look, I know his family and all that. You deserve a medal for sticking with him all this time. You ever thought of leaving him? You know, say it up on your own elsewhere.
Every day. Come on, let's get some fresh air.
I could do with it.
Yes, please, Mike.
Well, don't you think you've had enough?
Who says?
You'll thank me in the morning.
Cheers, mate.
Some point.
What's the problem? We found it in the water. In the harbour.
Mike! You haven't seen our Martin, have you?
Thank you. out.
Come on, get this lot out of here.
It's all right. Come on, you come with me, Carol. Come on, come on.
I didn't know George had a brother.
Well, they weren't close.
Where were they all last night?
In the pub.
Who was?
Well, George, brother Martin, his wife Carol and Steve.
Happy families, eh?
Yep.
What?
Nothing.
Was he drunk?
Yeah, I think so. He fell in, I expect, on his way back to his camper van.
Better go and see the experts, see if they back up your theory.
Take some time off if you want.
I'm fine. Look, let's get a couple of things straight, Mike, all right? I'm glad he's dead. Thrilled to bits.
Well, I'd keep that to myself if I were you.
He broke into the calf last night. I found him raiding the till. So I threw him out. Told him what I thought of him, too.
And that's all you did?
No. I hit him.
Oh, Steve.
Just the once. It was a weedy one as well.
You sure?
Of course I'm sure.
What?
He hit his head going down.
Come on, I asked you to move the crowd.
Come on.
Morning.
Nick.
Detective.
Long time no see.
Heard about your promotion. Congratulations.
You're not going to tell anyone all this, are you?
No, but you should before somebody else does.
But nobody saw me.
In a town like this, I wouldn't bank on it.
They didn't, Mike. I didn't see anyone else. Hang on, there was a van, a white van, near Martin's camp. Nearly knocked me over.
Make sure you get loads of photographs.
Mike, this is Detective Inspector Nick Preston, Mike Nichols, Harbour Master.
Hello, Nick.
Mike found the body.
How did he?
Just been confirmed that Martin was murdered.
Really?
You shouldn't be so close to the murder scene either. Not when we're collecting evidence. Stand behind the yellow tape.
Well, as the body was found in the harbour, actually, I've got every right to be here. It's my jurisdiction.
Last known movements?
He was in the pub with his wife, brother and nephew. Left around 10:30 and wasn't seen again.
Right, send uniforms in to interview the bar staff. We'll have a word with the family, but let's make sure we don't miss anything here first, eh?
So he's the new boss, is he? Hard luck.
It's all right. He's just filling in till we get our new replacement.
So what's the verdict? They know yet?
It was an accident, I expect, wasn't it?
No, he was murdered.
Murder? Oh, great. Well, that's going to keep our visitors away in droves, isn't it?
Oi, Mel.
I wouldn't be too sure about that, Tony.
Are you sure you're all right? We could leave this for a while.
I know this is difficult for you, Carol, but in cases like this, it is important for us to press on straight away. I'm sure you understand.
What is it you want to know?
What brought you to Brighthaven? Perhaps we should start with that.
Visiting relatives. George, Steve.
Discussions got a bit heated in the pub, by all accounts.
Just a few words, that's all.
How about?
Family squabbles, you know how it is. It was the booze talking, mostly.
Steve was heard to threaten Martin. Told him to drop dead. Is that right?
I'm sorry,
Who would want to see Martin dead, Carol? Can you help us with that? Did he have any enemies?
By the cartload. But none that have done this.
We will need Martin formally identified. Are you up to that?
I don't think I am, to be honest. Perhaps George.
Yeah, it's all right. I'll ask him. And if you need us, you know where we are.
So, you left with Carol?
Yes, she went for a stroll at the coast road.
You didn't see anything of Martin?
No, nothing.
What was the row about?
Oh, I can't remember now. Nothing serious.
What time did you leave Carol?
11:15.
And you didn't see your son at any point?
When?
Well, either when you left the pub or at home.
No, he was in bed when I got him.
You sure of that?
Yes. Well, I saw the light go off under his door when I was walking up the stairs.
Time?
11:30-ish.
He was involved in the death of a young man a while back, wasn't he?
But that was 8 years ago.
Boy he was fighting with died suddenly. Is that right?
It's just come up, George. Routine check on the computer.
But that was nothing to do with Steve. The boy's heart gave up. There'd been problems before, apparently. If you'd bothered to check, you'd know that.
That may be, but it still proves that Steve's no stranger to violence.
But Steve doesn't go around just thumping people for no reason. I mean, the boy that died, well, he was making a nuisance of himself. He was threatening him. I mean, Steve just lost his rag, that's all.
Which is exactly what he could have done with Martin last night. I have to tell you, we have a warrant to search your house.
Hey?
It's just a formality, George.
So if you'd like to come with us now, we can get it over with.
Steve, I'm in a very difficult position here.
Oh, well, I'm not.
Well, just tell him exactly what happened.
What, I was the last one to see him alive? Oh, and I knocked him out as well. I'd say that was me out of circulation for the next 10 years.
I don't think you set out to kill him. Of course I don't.
Oh, thanks.
But I know how the police operate. Any evasion to them means guilt, and that's when they really get their claws.
Right.
But I'll come with you if you like, all right? We'll sort something out, get it all out in the open.
No, I said, how many more times?
Steve!
Get off me!
It's not having any of this.
What, are you arresting me or what? I haven't done anything!
Steve, just calm down. This isn't going to help you.
No need for this. Leave him alone.
What's going on?
Your bell. How long have you known our Steve? You know he couldn't do anything like this.
George, I know that, but my feelings don't come into it. If they did, we'd be looking for someone else.
Called his mom when she told him to drop dead.
No, I didn't. He said that to me.
So you approached him at the harbour and then what?
I told him to clear off. He only ever shows up when he wants something, and I told him that.
Did you hit him?
Of course not.
Would you have known if you had?
I'd had a few drinks.
So I heard.
But I wasn't drunk.
So did you fight with him? Did you push him or shove him, maybe?
No.
So how do you account for the blood in your jacket?
I can't.
You can't? You can't. You're aware those bloodstains are being tested right now. And you still have nothing to say?
So you said your piece, then what?
I just walked away.
And Martin?
I don't know.
Where'd you go after that?
Home, of course.
Did anyone see you?
No, I just went straight to bed. But...
Yeah?
There was a van coming away from Martin's camper, nearly ran me over.
And?
Well, they might have had something to do with Martin's death. Look, I didn't do it. I wouldn't do that, Mel. You know me, don't you?
Steve, all we're trying to do here is eliminate you from our inquiries.
You could have fooled me.
No one is suggesting that you woke up yesterday with the intention of killing your uncle. But if you were to tell us that a fight got out of hand, or maybe there was an accident...
Martin was fit and well when I left him.
And you're sure of that?
Look, I need a break, a drink or something.
Okay. Interview terminated at 11:32.
It's all my fault, this, isn't it?
How'd you make that out?
Well, I'm big enough and daft enough to fight my own battles. Whatever Steve did last night, he was doing it for me. Just looking after his old dad, that's all. And I don't deserve it. Mel, please.
Second door on the left. 1 minute.
Steve.
Dad.
All right, son. All right.
What am I going to do?
Don't worry, we'll get you out of here. That's not a problem. We'll sell the cafe. I'll get you the best lawyer.
I didn't kill him.
No, I know you didn't.
I punched him, though. He got up again, I think.
You didn't mention a break-in, did you?
Of course not.
No, I told Melanie it was just kids. They mentioned Sam's death earlier.
What? That wasn't down to me.
Well, I know that, and I told them.
What are they bringing all that up again for? Even his family said I wasn't responsible.
You weren't responsible. Oh, this is all my fault, isn't it?
Of course not.
I wasn't there for you as a child. I was too wound up with my own
problems. Dad, this has got nothing to do with you.
I'm going to do the best I can for you now. I promise you that, son.
You think I did it, don't you? You think I killed him?
Steve.
Small town like this, it's bound to happen.
What is?
You're personally involved in this one, Mel. And that's always a bad thing. You're in CID now. It's a bit different from car theft and petty larceny.
Yes, I do know that, thank you very much. What?
I love it when you get angry. You broke my heart, you know, walking out at me like that.
Of course I did. I bet you were inconsolable for all of 5 minutes.
It wasn't like that. Listen, man.
What?
Fancy a drink later?
Yeah, why not? But listen, we'll have to be careful because we don't want two police officers personally involved, do we?
All right, George. How is he?
He's petrified, the poor kid.
Listen, Martin had words with Tony Simpson in the pub last night. What was all that about, I wonder?
Two crooks together, and you need to ask.
You reckon?
Well, they weren't squash partners, were they? Not as I can recall. This time it was Dodger designer gear knocked out in some sweatshop in Rotterdam. I was supposed to fence it through the cafe, wasn't I?
I mean, can you imagine it? What do you want with this? Chips or a pair of trainers?
Was Carol in on all of this?
Of course not. Listen, Carol's a diamond. How she put up with this skullduggery all those years, I'll never know.
Yeah, she was party to it all, George. She must have been.
You're on stony ground here, mate. Just leave Carol out of it. I won't have a word said against her. She needs a break now that Martin's dead. Never got one when he was alive, that's for sure.
Strange without Martin. I'm not used to being alone.
I'm here for your love, you know that. God, I hated him for running off with you.
What?
The police knew how much I hated him. Did I be in that police cell, not our Steve?
Well, he was very persuasive. Dynamic in those days.
And 20 years younger. I didn't stand a chance, did I?
You didn't fight for me, George. I was really hurt about that at the time, you know.
Me? Up against our Martin?
I loved you. Not him.
Why didn't you say?
Well, Martin turned me head. Sure he did. What I felt for you,
It's a lot more than I ever felt for Martin.
You mean to tell me in all those years I thought it was you that had dumped me?
Anyway, water under a bridge. 20 years too late.
What's your problem? You've got a real result here. Top quality goods at half price. I mean, what's £5,000 between friends? Yeah, all right, enemies then. No need to be pedantic about it. Yeah, pedantic. Oh, look, never mind. Look, I'm doing you a favour in common vernacular. And don't you forget it, this is a one-off. I've got far bigger fish to fry. Cold calling. Shocking. I thought they'd put a stop to all that.
Steve's been taken in for questioning.
Really? Well, I can't say I'm that surprised. I heard all about his antics in the pub last night.
Oh, come on, Tony, he's no killer.
Mind you, it's an ill wind. Trade's never been so good. Really put us on the map, this murder.
Only you can make capital out of a thing like this.
It's made me realise, you know, there's a market out there. You know, murder mystery weekends. Miss Scarlet in the library with a lead piping. I can make a killing.
You're branching out enough already, aren't you? Moving into the rag trade?
Yeah, it's just a sideline. Favour for some friends.
And learn from the real thing.
How dare you? They are the real thing.
You got these from Martin Blade, didn't you?
Look, Michael, I don't have to answer to you or to anybody else. Yeah? If you don't mind, some of us got businesses to run. Run along, let's go check.
Sorry, Mike. What's the problem?
Oh, no problem. No, I was just wondering if you're okay.
Oh, that's nice of you. I'm not doing too bad, thanks. What, any more news about Steve?
Well, not really. No, all sorts of forensic tests going on.
Let's keep our fingers crossed, eh?
Yeah.
Well, see you, Mike.
Yeah, that's it.
Carol didn't mention it at all?
No.
And they were definitely threatening her?
Looked like it. Pretty aggressive at one point.
Hi.
Hi.
Come in.
I hope you don't mind me popping in, though. It's just that,
Mike's just called in with some new information.
Really?
Yeah. What's your excuse?
Pardon?
No, I've just seen Carol Blade being threatened by two men in a white van. Got the registration number. Worth checking. Steve saw the same van being driven away from Martin's trailer last night.
Very public-spirited of you. But leave it to the professionals, eh? We know what we're doing.
Oh, yeah, of course. That's why you're holding the wrong man.
Steve Blade is our prime suspect for very good reason.
Yet the reason being you can't be bothered to follow up any other line of inquiry.
Mike, listen.
No, you listen. I'm fighting for Steve here. It's just a shame that I'm the only one.
Don't you dare talk to me like that.
Oh, why? Hit the mark, is it?
You saw what I did today. I put my job on the line for Steve.
Oh, really?
Yes. I allowed George to talk to him, which breaks every rule in the book.
Sorry, I forgot about that.
And I did it because he's a friend. And I don't believe for 1 minute Steve's a murderer. But I've got my job to do, and I can't turn a blind eye to evidence just because I know the suspect. And I am fighting Steve's corner, just like you're doing. But I'm doing it my way, right?
Yeah, well, with friends like you, doesn't need any more enemies.
Hello?
most murders are committed by people known to the victim. I don't have to tell you that, do I?
Yes, I've read the handbook.
We have a bloodstained jacket hidden, and reports of an argument involving said owner of bloodstained jacket with witnesses in double figures. We have separate reports of a family feud. And you think we got the wrong man?
Yes, I do.
And that's based on what? Don't tell me. Female intuition?
No, it is based on knowledge of the suspect. He's not a killer, Nick. He doesn't have it in him.
He's got a temper. We've seen that. And a history of violence. Look, he probably lashed out, did a bit more damage than he expected. Now he's in denial. Won't even admit to a punch.
Oh, he's scared stiff.
Well, the night in the police cells might jog his memory. Listen, we're going to talk about Steve all night.
No. You're going to get in your car and drive home. And I'm going to get in mine and do the same.
Are you sure?
Yes, I'm very sure. Night.
Mel, you know me. You know I don't go around killing people. I'm not a murderer.
I know you're not.
What am I doing here, then?
Off the record, I think Martin's death was probably accidental, in which case murder wouldn't even come into it. And a confession to that now would...
You're asking me to plead guilty to manslaughter?
I'm asking you to tell me the truth, Steve.
I have told you the truth.
If the evidence keeps pointing back to you...
What evidence? No one saw me kill Martin, did they? And all that stuff about Sam dying, why do you have to drag all that up like I'm a serial killer? Do you know what that did to my dad at the time?
It's just standard, it's police procedure.
The lad died of a heart attack. It was nothing to do with me.
Steve, I know that, but...
Melanie, can I have a word? Just had a positive match and a bloodstain from Steve's jacket.
They're Martin's.
Just been confirmed. CPS have given us the go-ahead. We can charge Steve with Martin's murder.
Right. Let's get on with it then, shall we?
Steve's been charged with murder.
Well, they must have evidence, Mike. I mean, they're pretty hot on that sort of stuff these days.
These clothes you're dealing in, you got them from Martin Blade, didn't you? And he got them from a couple of guys in Haymarth, is that right?
Sorry, did you want one?
Don't fob me off this time, Tony. I need to know where I can find them. And I'd be very careful if I were you.
Oh, yeah? Why's that?
So I'm sure the police will be very interested to hear that you had dealings with Martin just about the time of his death.
What? That had nothing to do with me, and I don't like being threatened. I'll tell you what you want to know to help Steve, and for no other reason. Have you got that?
Absolutely. So?
Will you? I'll give you back what we owe you this time. And double it.
You bottle it.
Just give me another chance. Martin messed up, not me.
You'd be dealing with every tinpot street dealer. And those even further down the food chain. Those boys take no prisoners, you know.
I can look after myself. Believe me. I've always had to.
All right. You've twisted my arm. But not a word to no one. You step out of line this time, and you'll be reacquainted with your late husband a lot sooner than you thought. Understand?
Understand.
Trust her?
Because no one else would.
At least you're all right, I suppose.
Oh, and that matters, does it?
Yes, of course it does. But really, Mike, you're going to have to stop all this boy's own stuff, you know.
I thought it suited me.
Must be freezing.
Here, put the kettle on.
You've done it now, love. No one crosses on us.
But I didn't have to tell anyone.
Oh, you bring your little minder along for the ride, did you?
No!
They were threatening Carol. Seems like Martin owed them. They agreed some kind of deal with her to work it off.
You're sure it was a drugs deal? The last time I heard, they were dealing in tracksuits.
We'll run a check on them, see if they got any form, but I know what I heard.
Maybe I'll do that.
Mel, call the fire brigade.
Sure you're all right?
Yeah, I've got some of Carol's things here.
It's probably best to give them to George.
We were moments away from another murder inquiry, you know that, don't you?
Yeah, I know, but why? What for?
You said she managed to persuade them to give her another chance.
Well, obviously something made them change their mind.
Yeah, we won't be able to speak to Carol till the morning. I'll see what the computer comes up with. Yeah, thanks, I got that. Dan French, 3 years for intent to supply. Judd Turner, 4 years for the same.
Yeah, well, I'm not one to gloat or anything.
Then don't.
So what next?
That's for Nick to decide, not me. Of course surveillance is justified.
And you think they'll still be there, do you? All their drugs in little sweetie jars labelled at the back of their HQ. Get real.
If we'd have taken them seriously in the first place.
The part-time drug dealers you haul in and throw back, they're worthless. Just forget them. Or hand your information over to the drug squad. They are not our concern. Steve Blade is.
Why won't you listen?
To what? Half-baked theories to get your little friend off the hook. You're a professional. Act that way.
Do me a favour. Stick to what you know. You want to impress Melanie? Show her your lobster pots. You'd have a much better chance. This is a police inquiry.
Oh, that's what you call it, is it?
And you are way out of your league, mate. Now back off.
What, and let rank incompetence take over?
What did you say?
Look, these two blokes have been involved in this right from the start. They almost killed Carol Blade tonight.
And you got proof of that?
Well, who else would do it?
You carry on like this, and I'll caution you. You got that? Harbour Master.
Don't threaten me!
Stop this right now, yeah? How are you?
I felt better.
Judd Turner and Dan French. Do you know them?
Melton did.
In what way?
He used to fence some stuff for them.
What type of stuff?
Clothes, mainly.
Anything else?
No.
It's just that we've had some information that suggests they were involved in drugs. Did you know that? Carol, you don't need to be frightened of them anymore. They've done a runner. Did they set fire to your camper last night?
I can't remember anything about last night. It's blank. I remember falling down. That's about it.
Why didn't you tell us about them when we started investigating Martin's death?
They threatened me, you see. They said if I said a word about them, I'd end up the same way.
So tell me about them. How was Martin involved with them?
Martin owed them, that's all. We'd sold a lot of stuff off for him. Only Martin has spent the money he should have paid back to them. Always doing that. Dropping us in it.
How much did he owe them?
3,000.
Enough to get him killed, do you think? Do you think Turner and French were responsible for Martin's death?
Do you think that we could, you know, talk about this later? I'm really tired.
Yeah. Of course we can. You take it easy. George sends his love. Said he might pop in later.
The problem is that although these two might have a motive for the killing, unless we can find them and they confess, there's nothing to link them to the crime. And without the evidence...
Well, the proverbial without a paddle.
Exactly. This is Carol's. There's some money in there and a few checks.
But where did you get this?
From our camper.
But, this is what Martin took the night he broke in. This is the only money that Steve didn't manage to get back.
Which means that Carol must have been given it by Martin or taken it from him the night he died.
Yeah.
Can I use your phone?
You're right. She's gone. So you saw Martin in the harbour, then what happened? Did you see him on the ground? Carol, if this was an accident...
It wasn't an accident.
Tell us what happened.
Steve punched Martin just once, and then he fell to the ground. When Steve left, I went over to Martin and he was grovelling about, a bit dazed, mumbling.
Things looking up, but I got some money.
Where from?
Never mind where from, just get me up here.
When he saw me, he held up his hand and I put my hand out to his.
And
couldn't lift him, not at that angle, he was too heavy.
Don't make me angry, Carol. You know what happens when you make me angry. Get me up, or I'll bloody kill you.
I looked down at him, drunk, dribbling.
Get me up, and I'll kill you. I mean it.
I pushed him back. I heard this sickening thud of him landing, and he just went over the side. And then nothing. And for a moment, I just froze. I mean, I couldn't believe what I'd done. I know you won't believe this, but I never intended for Steve to take the blame.
Well, I'm sure Steve would be glad to hear that.
So, what happens now?
Mike and George are waiting outside for you.
So that's it. It's over.
Yeah, you're free to go. Steve, I can't tell you how relieved I am to see you walk out of here. I know it didn't look like it, but I did try my best.
I know you did. Thanks.
Well, go on, then. Fated, aren't we?
Some things aren't meant to be.
I'm sorry, Steve.
Thanks, Mike.
Free the bride, Avon won, eh?
Well done.
What?
Sticking with your instincts.
You're leaving us tomorrow, is that right?
Yes, it is.
Something we said.
Never like to outstay my welcome. And besides, we got a result.
Arresting the right person, that must really be a result.
Well, I'll see you tomorrow then, Nick.
Yeah, you will. Night, Mike.
Yeah, night.
Steve hit Martin, didn't you?
Did Steve say that?
No, I said that.
Yeah, all right, I admit it. I'm guilty. So what's my punishment?
I'm working on it.